Hello, everyone. Okay, let's begin. I tried doing a live video message with my friends in Facebook, and it was everything that I said was cut up into pieces. So I will go in YouTube and see if I am more successful there. So let's begin. I will repeat my message that I said to my friends. Okay. Today is April 20th, 2020, and I had actually made the video at 2020, that's 8:20. So anyways, I continue. So I start all over again. I hope you're doing fine in your containment areas, wherever you are in the world, and that there's still the spirit of hope living within it. My name is Sylvain, and I'm here to have a productive chat with you about what could be the largest global crisis in human history, blamed on a virus, a very painful crisis which is unfolding before our eyes and the eyes of our children every single day. In this video, we'll be asking some simple questions about the crisis. We believe that some of these questions will resonate with you, perhaps even in your dreams. I believe that if we do ask the proper questions at some point, it will attract the answers that we need. Now, these questions are important regardless if you trust your government or if you are suspicious of their motives for crashing our global economy worldwide, all at once, all the nations of the world together, dashing our hopes as well. Throughout history, remember, governments have used lies to maintain control over the people and win wars, even cause wars. So it is right and just to ask our government leaders and other leaders questions while we still can, even if they refuse to answer them. They will answer our questions if we keep on asking them, though. Some of them will listen. And by the way, we can ask our questions to future leaders. Maybe they will listen. So with your creative and caring help right now, this short video will contain perhaps the best collection of these questions anywhere that we can share with others or send by regular mail to our current and future leaders starting tomorrow. If Facebook or YouTube decides to interrupt this video, another video will be aired and shared through two other platforms that I know at some other time. So our questions can grow and bear fruit somewhere else. People are entitled to ask questions, aren't they? If Facebook or YouTube decides to remove me from their platforms for asking intelligent, critical, and respectful questions, then so be it. All I can say to them is thank you for creating such a powerful platform that has allowed me to make thousands of friends around the world, to listen to hundreds of hours of videos that I've recorded. People who think just like me, people who love truth, peace, prosperity. And remember that peace depends on economic prosperity and truth. So there's much I have to cover, so I'll be brief. I'll start off by reading a list of questions that my friends and I have been asking last week about the crisis. Please listen carefully to our questions, and if they make you think of a new question, just add it in the comments below this video. With your help, this list may become the greatest collection of 2020 crisis questions available anywhere on the web. We don't have the answers to these questions, but they're important, worth asking our leaders. Some are even life-saving. It is my hope that you might consider sending one of these questions, even, in a handwritten letter to your leaders asking for answers. But so will we. We're going to do this. This week, starting this week, the week of April 20, 2020. So, we deserve answers that give us hope, I think. I'll number the questions in case you want to jot down your favorite one. And by the way, feel free to share this video with your friends and groups as I go along. Also, I pray to God that these questions will become a cornerstone to the beginning of a movement towards truth, transparency, freedom, and peace. It's very important for us to keep asking questions, always. Here are my questions. By the way, I will post the questions below in the comments. I'll read them off slowly. This is primarily for the benefit of my friends who do not read, who are blind, visually impaired. Okay, I'll start off. What will the world look like in the month of May? How long will the stimulus money last? How many more months will the global lockdown last? Are the lockdowns constitutional even in all countries? If so many people are infected, why are so many hospitals empty and in some cases staff is being released? If global lockdown lasts for just another month, won't that create chaos? What do nations do when all the stimulus money is gone? Why are more people experiencing more vivid dreams during the crisis? If governments just print money without backing, will this crisis change our whole society or the society, all the societies of the world? Will our societies break down even? Was the COVID virus ever isolated? If so, at what date and by what lab? Which lab? Nobody seems to know. I did an internet search. I can't find it. Since the death curves are flattening almost everywhere now, shouldn't authorities give us a little more slack somewhere? Instead, they're talking about testing, mandatory testing, mandatory tracing, mandatory isolation. It sounds like mandatory tyranny to me. Okay, go on. Are we being governed unjustly? Will they come to our homes to get a loved one who has a fever? Okay. Why are all the governments of the world, even their opposition parties, united in crashing all economies all at once at this particular time in history? Is the constant uncertainty and fear that we're experiencing, is it causing more damage to humanity than the virus itself? If we refuse mandatory vaccination, what will happen to us? Why do they stop surgeries, cancer treatments, when hospitals are empty? Why is 5G deployment being ramped up in the middle of a global pandemic? Shouldn't they turn it off, at least just for now? Instead, they're increasing it everywhere. 5G will be, all these towers will be installed by 2021. Is 5G harming military GPS equipment worldwide? Is 5G global rollout linked to the global coronavirus spread? Why is our Charter of Human Rights being violated, being no longer respected? Government leaders are saying that a vaccine will be ready only in 1 year to 18 months. Will the world be in revolt by then? What will be the state of the world in just 2 months from now? Why are our freedoms and privacies being slowly eroded week after week after week? Wasn't fear a major reason behind the Great Depression of the 1929-1939? Doesn't prolonged mass fear and isolation aggravate mental illness, crime, suicides? If the youth are rarely affected by this virus, shouldn't they be the first to return to work? The virus itself has not been isolated. So why is the whole world isolated by law? So why do we have to practice social distancing when our leaders and police officers don't? Just notice that next time. Two of them are sitting in the police car. I don't think they live together. Anyways, why can't we all go back to work while keeping a social distance and wearing masks, gloves, whatever it takes? People want to go back to work. They'll be safe. Look at doctors and nurses. They touch people every day, and they're okay, most of them. Why can't we visit local farms, empty fields, empty parks? Is the pandemic being used to create a new cashless society? Don't authorities realize that economic collapse and unemployment are destroying families? Why don't authorities show clear evidence of the necessity of indefinite lockdown everywhere on the planet right now? Why are the media and government working hard, hand in hand, promoting fear and hopelessness globally day by day? You don't hear any glimmer of hope from them at all. Everything is doom and gloom. If restaurants become permanently closed, then wouldn't grocery stores become the only source of food for most of humanity? Is the coronavirus test designed to test the presence of a virus, antibodies to the virus, or rather to test the presence of a genetic sequence that may be commonly found in many people? Why does the media avoid, just a second here, okay. Sorry about that. My little technical problems here. Okay. Where was I? Oh, yeah. Why does the media avoid other facts about the crisis? Mental health issues, suicides, unemployment, education, etc. Almost done. Why are all religions of the world silent about the intentional destruction of the global economy and freedoms? Why are children at almost no risk of a highly contagious disease that has circled the globe? Why have such extreme and dangerous measures for such a virus less deadly than the seasonal flu? Why aren't the different industry associations and unions speaking out to reopen the world for the sake of their workers and the businesses they represent? If governments are genuinely concerned about our health, why are millions of us without a family doctor, and why do we have to wait 20 hours in a crowded emergency waiting room? Why can't restaurants start selling and delivering value-added groceries or alcohol? After China's deadly coronavirus lies, why is Europe trusting Beijing on 5G? Why isn't China under investigation by more countries than just the United States? Okay. Why doesn't the whole world not boycott China, or why aren't there any embargoes? I guess they're waiting for the result of the investigation. This could be painful. So why are world leaders fervently agreeing with each other right now, even those at war, they're collaborating about a virus? Why aren't visitors allowed in empty hospitals to visit their loved ones? And finally, why aren't leaders avoiding to answer any of the above questions? Now, this is a list of questions that came from me and my friends. If there is one question in this list that meant something to you, that resonated with you, please share that question with your friends, with your groups that you belong to, and with a political representative. By the way, as I said earlier, mailing a handwritten letter in an envelope to a leader is more effective than emailing, more effective than petitions. Emails and petitions can be deleted by artificial intelligence, but letters must be opened by humans and read. You can't go to jail for what you're thinking, so mail away. So, if our leaders won't answer our questions, I'll find people who will. We'll find people who will, starting the week of April 20, 2020. I'm done. Feel free to email me at sylvain.henry@gmail.com, sylvain.henry, like the chocolate bar, @gmail.com, if you have any further questions or ideas or comments. And before I go, I would like to tell you what I believe in. And I just would like to leave you with these words. I believe in many things, but regarding this crisis, I believe in two things above all else. First, I believe that women will somehow save humanity in this global crisis, and the people of the world will support them for whatever it is they do. I believe that strongly. I will tell you why in another video. And two, I think that May 14th, 2020 could very well be the point of no return. After that time, we will be entering a new phase of the world, and society will definitely start to suffer. I hope I'm very wrong about that, but others feel as I do, and with reason, and I'll share that in a future video. So, that's it. Thank you for your time. Sylvain from Gatineau signing off.